Hey everybody, Brian Inskip here with mybuyerlisting.com, and really excited today because we've got a very special guest that's going to share his wisdom on what it takes to live a life without limits. So today we're going to be talking with Adam Hergenrother. He's really just an outstanding leader that enjoys helping other people achieve their goals in life. So we're very fortunate to have Adam with us here today. Just to give a little background and introduce Adam, for those of you that don't know him, Adam was born and raised in Vermont. He's the CEO and chairman of the board of Hergenrother Enterprises. That includes Keller Williams Realty Vermont, Hergenrother Realty Group, BlackRock Construction, Hergenrother Capital, Adam Hergenrother Training Organization, and the Hergenrother Foundation. So that's quite a list there, quite an empire that you've built. But what really gets me on that is that a lot of this wasn't around 8 years ago. Is that right?
Yeah, I mean, I literally about, this has been in the works for about 6.5 years now. I got my license in late 2006 and started building from there.
That's amazing. That is trucking right along. What I really love about Adam is Adam's well known for taking on a huge vision and then just attacking it full force. And you've kind of adopted the term of living a life without limits. So whatever you can believe, you can achieve if you're willing to go after it.
I look at my life and I said, look, I never wanted anybody to put myself and my thinking in a box. And so when I developed that thinking and that mindset that I was never going to live in mediocrity, and I'll explain why I got there later on, but when you actually understand that core concept, you start applying that to every aspect of your life. The really neat thing is, Brian, is when you actually adopt these models in your life, they actually apply into any other business that you want to implement. And that's what it is. It's about building the models and systems, and your life becomes free of mediocrity when you have that and you have the confidence to go forward with it.
That's awesome. So Life Without Limits, this course, this is not a real estate course is what I'm hearing you say. It's not specific to any one industry. This is about fundamentals. This is about a way of thinking that you can apply to any business goal or any life goal that you have.
It's really truly living that life where it's physical, it's business, it's social, it's family, it's spiritual, it's all those components, because that's what living a life is, right? If you can live on that edge of disruption, right, in perpetuity, where opportunity meets the edge of disruption. If you're there and you're lying there, that's where life becomes real, and that's where real success and fulfillment will come from. It's not just positive thinking. It is literally here are actionable items and steps that you can put into your life right now so that when you leave there, you have progressional operations that you can move forward with to ensure that you're actually going to move the needle in your life. I really come from a place of servant leadership and an opportunity to get you guys to break free of mediocrity. And ultimately, 80% of success in business or success in personal life building is psychology. 20% of it is actual mechanics. And so there is so many courses, classes, books that talk about how to do a listing presentation, how to do a buyer presentation, how to work on this script. A lot of you guys there are already at that upper level. You guys know how to do that. My job is to come in here and serve you guys in a way where you're going to be able to walk out of there and say, look, I'm thinking differently now. I understand where I can raise my level of leadership lid. I can see different angles and different attitudes, and I can actually empathize better with my team. So it's designed to really bring you full force and to change the way we're thinking throughout a course of a day. When you stop being intellectual and you actually understand this viscerally, even with that place behind your stomach, when you come from that place and it's not a challenge to do it in your mind, that's where you can able to take your life to live the biggest life possible, whatever that means for you. And that's the cool thing about it. It's designed to whoever it's unfolding for you and whoever you are and whoever your strengths are to be able to push forward.
That's awesome, man. So I want to talk about kind of the dark side of that, okay? It's easy to look at somebody that's accomplished the things that you've accomplished and say, well, you know, the stars must have been magically aligned for Adam. But I would imagine that you've encountered a roadblock or two on the way to where you're at now, and that those roadblocks aren't over, that you'll encounter more.
Yeah, I mean, people and money, right? I think those are the number one things. When you begin to leverage, first of all, leverage is a very wonderful word, because leveraging means you're giving somebody else an opportunity. It doesn't just mean you're taking things off your plate. It means you're giving somebody else an opportunity to grow their family's life. They give somebody else the opportunity, so it's a trickle-down effect every time you're able to leverage. However, as we know, when you start adding people into your life, and it's not just you reaping the benefits of your own reward, you have people that are acting, talking, walking, and reflecting your organization. And we're all shocked at times what people do in within an organization. So your biggest problems are going to be people. And the different, so the leadership skills, if you look at this from leveraging standpoint of building this life, is going from I do it to we do it to they do it. And it's a topic Gary talks a lot about. But the interesting thing is there's a different leadership skill and a different leadership lid in each one of those categories. Most of us can master I do it. A lot of us will get to we do it, but can you take that next step and get to they do it? And that's the crucial part of it, is you empower people to they doing it. You're giving them the opportunity to grow your organization, giving you the opportunity to go and master all other aspects of your life to do it. And that's what I want to walk people through, to how do you get into they doing it and being able to allow that to happen. And then obviously you have money. You know, I started off my business by borrowing $8,000. I took the first $4,000 of that, and look, I was living in a 400-square-foot apartment. I was in real estate for a couple months, like 30 days. I borrowed $8,000. I didn't have anything, right? But look, our belief in HRG, right? So there's always, our belief is that there's always a way. There's always a way to make things happen. And so when you borrow $8,000, I took $4,000 of that and invested into myself. I went to a Howard Britton conference, came back, and I failed my way forward fast. So while you're going to have problems building businesses, the key is to fail as fast as possible so that you can learn from your mistakes. Use that as fuel so when you take on your next opportunity.
Awesome. A lot of people will look and say, you know, if I could think positive like that, if I could think outside of the box, if I could have Adam's attitude, then I'd be able to do those kind of things. But, even being the positive guy that you are, even having the motivation and the drive that you have, was there ever a time that you didn't think it was going to work out where that doubt crept in?
You know, there, I still do. I mean, that's the short answer of it. The interesting thing is there's a difference between allowing your mind to slip for a second and say, am I going to make it? And then correcting that thinking and going, you know what? I know that no matter what the outcome of this is, that I'm going to work through it. And I think there's two different ways to do this. If you try to pretend like you're never going to have those thoughts in there, it's not, I haven't found somebody yet that does that. And for a while, Gary Keller even asked the question, are we going to make this, right? He's been open about that. And so I think you need to understand is as you're building a business and you have those doubts, you need to understand, you take that doubt and you say, look, it's there, it's real, that's okay. It's going to, I understand that. But look, I'm confident in knowing that I'll be able to figure it out, whatever the outcome is. If you truly understand that where you are is exactly where you're supposed to be right now. Life unfolds for us and not to us. And the more we can embrace that, we're going to understand that maybe there's somebody that's shuffling ourselves to exactly to be listening to this message, to hear this, to come to this class, to understand where you can break free, and to understand that there is no, look, just because you failed something doesn't mean you're a failure. There's a big difference. We fail at things every single day. It doesn't mean that any of us are failures. What it means is that we're human.
Sounds like it's not necessarily about that first thought that comes to mind or the circumstance that you're faced with. It's what you do when that's right there in front of you. It's that next
move. You know, Brian, problems are a sign of life. People want to wake up every day and not have problems. Well, if you really want to wake up and not have problems, you should go lie in a box, because every day, no matter how much money you have, how many people you have in your life, you're going to be hit with a series of problems on a daily basis. Success actually comes in spurts, right? You actually have far more losses than you do wins. The goal is, can you stay emotionally fit enough during that time as you're building your organization to be able to push through those losses to hit that geometric curve, that spurt of success? By the way, research shows that geometric growth doesn't happen until 5 to 7 years of the grind. And the grind is what people go through. And if you don't have clarity and strategic alliance of bringing yourself through that grind, you're going to doubt yourself every day. Just know that every business leader, every business organization goes through that grind. And the majority of the time, you just don't see them until they hit their geometric curve. And that's when they get labeled of an overnight success. And they go, well, hold on, stop. You guys are just not seeing the last 10 years of my life. You haven't seen the sacrifices we've made, the risks that we've had to take, the visions that we have to set, the people that I've had to deal with in order to put ourselves in this position today. Everyone's going to have a different version of who they want to become. And I think the key is to have a strong enough why so that it carries you through those dark moments of the night that you're going to have. So my personal mission statement is every day I wake up is to grow spiritually through life's experiences by creating a world large enough that any one of my team members can exceed any goal possible. And so when I wake up with that, my job is to, how do I create a world so big that nobody ever has to leave my organization?
That's cool. That makes every life an adventure, every life every day a discovery. So, you know, the interesting thing about it, Adam, is whether you're, settling for mediocrity, or let's say you did throw in the towel, there's grind on either side of that. At the end of the day, the only difference is what result you end up in your life, if that's aligned with what you want your life to be about and what you want the people around you to experience in their life.
You know, that's a really awesome point. But the cool thing is that's where life is. No matter what level you want to get to, if you're not pushing yourself, if you're not living on that edge, if you're not willing to live in perpetuity there, then you're missing out on the growth aspect of life. And that's where the journey is. And I think that, you know, success without fulfillment is the ultimate failure in life. And Tony Robbins uses that quote. But it's just such a strong word in my mind, because you can have fulfillment, but if you have success without that, well, then what's the point, right? But if you have success that's tied to fulfillment, then every experience that you have every day, whether that's negative or positive, is going to be part of your growth path, which is then making you and growing you into a bigger human being and a better person, better father, better husband, better mentor, and better partner.
Awesome. So you've been teaching Life Without Limits. You've been living it. What do you think keeps most people from taking that on?
Fear. Ultimately, it's fear paralyzes people and immobilizes it. And, you know, I've written blogs on this, and there's been a lot of research done on it. Fear will stop anybody from going anything. There's two primary fears, and we get into this a lot in Life Without Limits, of fear of not being enough and fear of not being loved. And you can actually, you know, fear of failure of success, by the way, fear of failure of what people could, if I hire people, then why do they need me? There's all sorts of hundreds of fears that are out there that all point back to fear of not being enough and fear of not being loved. And the thing is you can never, Brian, get rid of fear, right? You have to understand that if you can learn to dance with fear and use it as fuel for your fire, then you'll ultimately no longer understanding that there's always going to be fear in my life. But if you can take that and use it as fuel, then that creates courage, which then creates this virtuous cycle so that you understand that every time you're on the edge, you need to fear that kind of fear so you can break through that. That's being purposeful and breaking through the models and systems of your life so you reach the next level. And if you go, if you go long enough in your career, months, maybe it's 2 months, maybe it's a year, whatever it is for you, without feeling fear, the question I'd ask yourself is, are you truly pushing yourself to the limit that you can? If you can't run, you crawl, you walk. If you can't walk, you crawl. If you can't crawl, you drag yourself along. But what you can't do is stop moving forward. If you work on something long enough and you're able to stay emotionally fit through there, it'll break. It'll bend, and all of a sudden you're in the clear, and you just gain so much knowledge of being resourceful in your life. And when you put that into it, that's when you can really start living on the edge, because you know you're always going to be able to figure it out.
It's awesome. So obviously you've got a lot of passion around this, Adam. You got a lot of wisdom around it, a lot of experience to bring to the table. There's a lot of things you could be doing with your time. So you're traveling around teaching Life Without Limits now. Why is it that's become a priority for you?
Well, I think everybody deserves the right to live a life without limits. I truly do. And if there's something that I can do to get to, you know, a couple people in that class, and not all of them, to cause them to think differently, to grow their family differently, to grow their business differently, to provide another opportunity, then we're constantly going out there and being a force for good, right? I don't like to, the last 7 years, I've spent so much money invested in myself and the coaching and the training and time and energy away from my family. I don't want to see that go to waste. What I want to see that go to is being used to allow other people to get out there and break free of mediocrity and to live their life so they really truly want to go out there. And if I can have an impact on somebody's life and I can leave part of their legacy beyond because I've got them to change their thinking of that, and not just necessarily give them a tool, but change how they critically think down below, then ultimately I've served my purpose here to creating that world large enough for everybody else to continue to live.
That's great, man. So what are people going to walk away with? They come spend the day with you and other business leaders. We're going to be talking about life limits. What are they going to walk out with at the end of that day?
they're going to walk out with a changed way of thinking. They're also going to walk out with action steps that are designed to take what we've learned in that day and apply it on a daily basis, right? You're going to have all the tools, models, and systems that you need to break free of mediocrity, to break free of where you are, or if you're just stuck, or if you don't know where to begin, you're going to have all the tools, models, and systems. And the difference between what I like to do is there's a lot of classes that will give you the tools, models, and systems. They're actually free everywhere, right? So why don't people just use them? It's because they approach it mentally differently. So the beginning part of this is to get you to think a little bit differently, to understand that 80% of success is psychology, 20% is mechanics. We're going to work on the 80%, and then I'm going to give you the 20% of everything we've done, spent millions of dollars on to create for models and systems. You can have that, right? We give that away for free. Most people don't do anything with it unless I can get you to think differently about how you approach these things. And when that happens, you're all of a sudden going to never be able to go back to the old way of thinking, because in your mind's been expanded to believe and think bigger and go from exponential, you know, from local and linear to exponential and global, and which we'll talk about that a lot in the class itself.
Excellent. And that's so important, man, that you're bringing both of those together, because usually it's one or the other. You're getting the how-to, yeah, or you're getting pumped up, and that just leaves that gap. So that's when you know it's coming from experience and coming from a set that's been down that road, that you got to have both.
By the way, also, if your wife or partner is not with you, or husband, then it's a really cool thing to do is to bring them as well too, because that way when you leave there, how many people have been to a class and you're so excited about it and you come home and you're like, oh my God, this guy said this and this is great and this is what we're going to do and we're going to change this, it's going to be awesome. And your partner's like, what? Like this, did you just like drink some coffee or something? And so if you can bring them to align yourself so that you come back and you have a household that's supporting the vision, values of your new thinking, it's going to accelerate your growth, the growth of your family and everyone else around you. You know, I'm privileged to be able to serve you guys out there, and I don't take your time away from your business, your family, lightly at all. So the amount of time that you give, I'm going to pour everything in that I've got. We continue to refine this course. We teach it regularly, continue to refine it based on feedback. So I'm really, really excited to bring to you guys the full vulnerable, you know, all the aspects of our life that we have, and really sharing you with true stories about how things are truly built, the hard things about hard things, right? And so that we come from that place. So I'm really excited that you guys are allowing me to go out there and serve you guys for an entire day. And I'm really looking forward to it, Brian.
Yeah, well, your passion's contagious, Adam. So certainly appreciate you taking the time out today. And we're pumped. I hope everybody that watched this is pumped now and already getting registered. So let's have an awesome day. And again, appreciate it, Adam.
Awesome. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Everybody.